Hey everyone, Anthony here. Yes, I'm finally back, and welcome to the 2020 tour of my room, my setup, and all of my YouTube gear. Now, I do already have a couple of videos on the progression of my setup, and there's also last year's room tour, but this is basically all of that combined into one video, along with any changes that I've made or new things that I've added. Overall, the room is just a lot more complete, so I figured that an updated room tour was worth uploading. Let's get started. I'm going to start at the door area and slowly work my way in. As you can see, I've got a couple of movie posters in this area. I'm not a serious poster collector by any means, and some of these were actually freebies from my local movie theater, rest in peace, but they still look cool and I definitely think that they make my video backgrounds a little more interesting. I also have an exit sign above the doorway, and an old Mars poster from National Geographic. Alright, let's talk about the shelf. It appears in the background of pretty much every single one of my videos, which is why I have a light strip behind it so that it looks a little more interesting. On top, I have an essential oils diffuser to keep the room smelling fresh. Moving on down, we've got a row of miniature storage bins that I bought from Target. They're all labeled with whatever I keep inside. For example, I have a whole drawer dedicated to my old fidget spinner collection, if you happen to remember those. I have a pretty hefty collection of pens and pencils, a bunch of random GoPro accessories, a couple of Raspberry Pis for those of you into DIY tech, cable adapters, mini tripods, and a whole drawer full of tape. On the shelf right below, I have my collection of old cameras, and if you've been following me for a while, you'll know that I like to collect these. Some of them work, some of them are broken, and others kind of work. Regardless, I think vintage cameras are a super cool thing to collect, and they make for good props in my videos. Right below is really just storage for a bunch of miscellaneous items. I have some more pop figures, and also a stuffed loot llama that my sister Francesca got me for Christmas a while back, so, thank you Francesca. I have some vintage flashes that go with the cameras above, a Sony Walkman of some sort, a basket of Nerf darts, and a bunch of old boxes for various cameras and phones. Let's talk about my other shelf. This is literally one of the cheapest shelves you can buy on Amazon. It's made of particle board and PVC pipes, and I don't really recommend it, but if you load it right, it is surprisingly solid. On top is an old fake plant, and also my old set of Logitech computer speakers. Down below, I've got my collection of toy drones, and this one right here was actually the first tech review I ever did. Then, I have my green screen and a regular old sheet, a bunch of school-related books, and the box for my headphones as a makeshift bookend. Alright, now the moment you've probably been waiting for, my setup. Let's start with the desk. I built it as a fun project with my grandfather a little over a year ago, and I'll admit that I'm not the handiest person when it comes to tools, so building this desk was definitely good practice. I think it's about 7 feet long, so I can fit everything on it and still have a little room to spare. I paid for the materials myself, and it served me really well so far. Moving on to my triple monitors, I've got a really nice LG 29-inch ultrawide in the middle, and two crappy TVs on either side. The ultrawide is on top of this wire frame stand that I found at Target, and then I have one TV on top of an old record player, and then the other one mounted vertically on a Vivo monitor arm. My dark gray Google Home Mini sits here, supposedly as my loyal robot servant, but really, it's just a glorified alarm clock. I have some math supplies in the drawer, including my calculators, and on this side right here, I've got a couple of external hard drives. I have a Himalayan salt lamp that adds a nice vibe to my setup and looks cool in the background, and right behind it is where I put a tripod so that I can use my DSLR as a webcam. For audio, I'm using a pair of Mackie CR3 studio monitors with blue trim. The CR3s produce very clean and detailed sound, and they definitely made me a more discerning listener when it comes to audio. I also have a pair of the original HyperX Cloud headphones, which are big and comfortable, and so far I haven't really seen the need to upgrade. They're hanging on this rubber headphone hanger that sticks on underneath my desk for easy access, so I just grab them, plug them into my speakers, and I'm ready to go. For voiceovers, I have a pretty basic mic setup, which is just a Blue Yeti mounted on an arm and plugged into my PC. The Blue Yeti is what you're listening to right now, and overall it's a high quality microphone that is really easy to use. I will admit that I'm not an expert when it comes to audio, but so far it's worked for me, so I guess that's good. My mouse and keyboard haven't changed since the last 3 setup videos I made, and to be honest, I doubt they will for a while. My MX Master 2S is still a solid and very comfortable mouse, and my E-Element mechanical keyboard is the perfect size to just slide underneath the monitor stand if I need it out of the way. Of course, no setup is complete without RGB lighting, and I do have a basic remote-controlled strip behind the desk. I also have a smart bulb and an old lamp behind one of the TVs. It's an inexpensive bulb from a company called Tekken, and it connects to the Wi-Fi network and is fully controllable with my phone, which is a slightly older Samsung Galaxy S8. I also have another Tekken smart bulb mounted in a softbox that I've been using to light most of the B-roll so far. Right underneath the lamp, I have what I like to call my quick grab basket, which is basically just filled with small items that I might need to grab at a moment's notice. For example, the RGB remotes, my wallet that is sadly devoid of money, a multi-tool, and my earbuds. Underneath the desk, I've stored a whole bunch of things. On top of this drawer right here, I have a Nerf gun that slides right out for easy access, very helpful for keeping little brothers away, highly recommend. There aren't a whole lot of interesting things in this drawer, basically just a rat's nest of cables, and some old supplies and papers. I've got some photographic printing paper that I had to buy for a photography class, my camera backpack, and I've got my PC. So originally my PC was just the cheapest one I could find at Best Buy, but from there I pretty much just bought upgrades whenever I could afford them. The first thing that I added to my PC was an SSD, and this is one of the most important upgrades you could possibly make for a PC. SSDs are much faster than hard drives and I highly recommend them. In fact, I would even go so far as to say that you shouldn't buy a new PC unless it comes with an SSD, because otherwise you're just in for hours of frustration with the hard drive. The next thing that I upgraded was the RAM, and this is the original stick, it's 8 GB, and this is the box for the new stuff, which is 16 GB. The next thing that I upgraded was the processor, and I think it was originally a really crappy AMD A10, but the upgrade was a proper 8-core Ryzen 7, so pretty fast. That's pretty much all I can say about it. And then the next thing that I upgraded was the graphics card. Again, this is the original, it's a 2 GB RX 560. And then here's the box for the upgrade, which is an 8 GB RX 580. I can play Minecraft at max settings, you know how it is. It's worth mentioning that I bought both the PC and the upgrades with money that I earned myself, with the exception of the 16 GB of RAM, that was a Christmas gift from my dad, so shout out to him. Should I have just saved my money and bought a nicer PC in the first place? Yeah, probably, but to be honest, all of these upgrades have made me really comfortable opening up the PC, working inside, and troubleshooting any problems that I encounter, so that's definitely a good skill to have. Anyway, that was pretty fun. Oh, it's dark. Alright, if you're enjoying this video so far, please consider checking out the rest of my channel. I make short films, I do a lot of editing tutorials, I review different tech and gear, and of course I do have a few other videos about the progression of my setup, so if you're interested in any of that, consider subscribing and also following me on Instagram at anthony.toons. Now let's continue the room tour with a behind the scenes look at my camera gear and how I make my videos. To start with, we've got my lighting setup. I'm using a pair of softboxes from a company called Andor, and I've had them for almost a year. My tripod is from Viltrox, it's the VX18M, and it's what I've been using for most of these B-roll shots. I also get asked all the time what camera I use, and I use a Nikon D5600 with my two favorite lenses, the 35mm prime and the 10-20mm wide angle. It's a great photography camera, and it's decent for video, especially since it has a flip-out screen, so if you're a Nikon fan, I highly recommend it. I store all of this gear in my Tarian Pro camera backpack, which is an absolutely massive backpack with all the room I could ever need for any kind of gear. It's definitely a specialty backpack though, and not one I'd recommend for normal backpack use. For most things like school, I use a backpack from Swiss Gear, and Swiss Gear makes really high quality stuff. I've had this for maybe 5 years, and it's still in really great condition. Alright, time to wrap things up with the storage area in the back of my room. Sitting on top of an old nightstand, I have an Echo Dot and a Fire HD8 that's paired with an Arctic Bluetooth keyboard. The Echo Dot is actually a lot nicer than the Google Home Mini in my opinion. It has higher quality sound, physical buttons, and most importantly, it has cooler lights. As you can see, I have Christmas lights on this shelf instead of an RGB light strip, which is nice because it mixes things up a little, and I've got a crap ton of stuff organized semi-neatly. A whole bunch of things are just hidden away in these shoe boxes. I've got sunglasses, old boxes, swim goggles, yeah. I have an Osmo Mobile 2 that I still use from time to time, I also have the laptop that I used to edit on, which is a 2012 HP Pavilion. Super old, and it can't even connect to the Wi-Fi anymore for some reason, so it kind of just sits here and gathers dust. I've also got several boxes of light bulbs at different brightness levels and color temperatures, a basket with a bunch of rechargeable battery supplies, a Fire HD 6 tablet that Amazon no longer sells, and this light up stick thing. I also just have a bunch of random props and stuff on the shelf back here, stuff like these dismembered hands that were originally part of a Halloween costume and now I just use them occasionally in videos. I've got a hat, a watch, screen wipes, I've got a VR headset for like my phone, this winter hat that I think my grandma knitted, a couple of face masks, very important, especially now. Yeah, all sorts of random stuff. So there you go, my ultimate behind the scenes room and setup tour for 2020. Hopefully this video gave you some ideas and inspiration for your own room or setup, and if it did, be sure to let me know by leaving a like. Also subscribe if you haven't already, and thanks for watching.